547, Pip Emma, time to report.
Leader Cunningham Jarvis at your service, my dear.
Dr. Swan would like a word with you about your wife. If you wouldn't mind just stepping into the waiting room for a moment with Mr. Southgate. Mrs. Southgate's in Carberry too.
Fair enough. There you are.
Prepare yourself.
Oh. Right.
I'm very sorry.
Fine.
So you're not in any pain?
Not anymore.
I'll go and sit with her. She'll know I'm there. She knows it's me.
I'm sure she does.
Shirts. I'm having plenty of clean shirts, dear.
Fine, fine. Getting a bit low on fags.
Son of a...
What? What did you say? I can't hear.
I said there'll be some at the pub.
You
go on, Reggie.
Sure. I can't stand hospitals, never could.
We met.
What?
In a hospital.
Oh, yes. So we did.
Nurse? Nurse Bagnall? Nurse Bagnall?
Could you draw the curtain round?
What's the matter? Should I get a sister?
No. Just draw the curtain.
What is it?
Listen, they're letting me out tomorrow. Will you meet me? White Hart, 8 o'clock.
No, I couldn't. I couldn't possibly.
Why not? Some other lucky beggar got there first.
No.
All right, I'll be waiting. I shan't leave till you come.
See you tomorrow, gal.
Little Ashley next door. He was showing me his new bike today. Got me thinking of that first holiday we had. on the bikes before I got posted. I'm ever so sorry.
Pardon?
About your wife.
Oh, right.
My wife passed away as well, within a few minutes of yours, Sister said, so I know how you must be feeling.
Absolutely. Yes. Do look on the bright side, Hart.
Service, Vicar. We were all so fond of Mary. Girls especially. Will you excuse me? Vivian.
Aye?
Go and ask your Uncle Reggie what he's got laid on next, would you?
All right. A flick.
Cecil.
Come and help me out.
Okay.
Thank you for making such an effort. Appreciate it very much.
Uncle Reg, deepest sympathy. All went off splendidly, I thought. Lovely old shirt.
Mm. We're all so sorry, Uncle Reggie. We'll miss her so much.
Really?
So, what have you got in mind now?
What do you mean?
Well, drinks and so on. Anything planned?
Oh, good God, never thought about it. That was all Mary's department, that sort of thing. No, nothing arranged. Sorry, eh?
Ah, well, not to worry. Why don't you come up to London, join us for dinner and stay the night?
Oh, we'd really like it if you felt you could. Please, Uncle Reggie.
Oh, no. Thank you very much. Better on my own.
Fine. That's how you feel.
Reggie.
Thank you.
beautiful service.
Thank you very much. Look at that. Lord Blythe Gowrie, that is. Chairman of the family farm and an arsehole of the first water. Where have I seen you before?
At the hospital. My wife.
Oh, got it! Never forget a face. Well, what do you say? Fancy a sharpener?
All right, then.
Poor old thing. That does seem a bit awful, just leaving him.
Nonsense, Celia. Couldn't wait to see the back of us. I find a permanent air of resentment hard to take, as if he's been done down in some way. Well, in fact, he's been drawing 20,000 a year for the firm, doing sweet damn all for it for the past 40 years.
Well, how did he get on without Aunt Mary?
As far as I can see, he took her completely for granted while she was there, so whether he'll miss her or not, a moot point.
At least he stayed with her.
Best wife a chap ever had. You know, we never even had a crossword. I think she turned a blind eye to. Not even a black look. Not a dick of burden. One in a million. Fancy another.
Oh, well, thanks. Not much of a drinking man, not really. I'll better be off.
Fair enough. Large one in there, my dear. So you're off then, are you?
Yeah, it's my wife's funeral, Thursday. 11 o'clock, St. Thomas's Priory Road, if you'd care to come.
I don't quite see the point of that. Oh, right, a quid pro quo. Fair enough, I suppose.
Yeah, I'll be off then. One day at a time, eh?
No, anything to sell, Jeff. Ah, that's more like it. And what about you, my dear? Could you handle a large one? Mary!
Talking Jerry or Popsy?
That little nurse, am I right?
Possibly.
Here's to yours, Reggie. Never grow shorter.
Here.
Him, all mouth and trousers. I could tell her how he was feeling now. Same as me. I'll be all right, as you watch. He'll be proud of me.
For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God of his great mercy to take unto himself the soul of our dear sister Grace Southgate, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Mr. Southgate. I'm Mandy Hume from Social Services. Did you get my letter?
Yeah, but you said 10 o'clock.
Yes, I'm sorry, I'm a bit early. Would you like me to come back later?
No, that's all right, since you're here.
Okay. Thank you.
Just doing a spot of housework.
So I see. Oh, Mr. Southgate. That's beautiful.
That big one was taken on VE Day. She paid a street photographer half a crown to get that picture taken for me.
She looks very happy.
She was. Cup of tea?
Oh, yes, please, if it's no trouble. No need to ask if you're coping. Some of my clients find it very hard. Some of them you think they'd never set foot in the kitchen.
But we always shared, and the last few months I was doing just about everything. So you can cross me off your list.
Were any of your family able to attend the funeral?
No, our daughter Vera is in Australia. She would have come, but I told her she needn't, so she didn't.
And your son?
No. No, there was a lot of people there, what with me being on the milk and Grace doing dinners at the school, but I wouldn't say we had that many friends, not close friends.
Roy? Roy?
What?
How many times do you think we've done it now?
You tell me.
417.
Smashed the record for the three-legged race.
Roy! Can you feel it?
Yeah.
It's little Alan.
Or Vera.
Did you know that you can get lunch every weekday at the community centre? It's only 75 pence and it's really quite good.
Did you know that at the Feathers down the road you can get a damn good lunch for £7.50 with half a bottle of wine thrown in? I'll teach you if you like.
So what you're saying is I don't need to worry about you?
Exactly.
Well, I would still like to see you again.
I'm delighted to hear it.
So, say, 2 weeks from today at about the same time?
I've got a better idea. What say I take you to dinner tonight?
That's against regulations, I'm afraid. But thank you for asking. It's very kind of you. So, 2 weeks from today.
Right, fair enough.
So, how was it then? Funeral.
Much you care. You could have come yourself if you'd had any consideration. Don't tell me you couldn't have got a pass, because I know you could have.
It's not as simple as that, Dad, and well you know it.
She would have wanted you there.
No, she wouldn't. She was ashamed of me, same as you are.
Your mother loved you, Alan. Nothing changed her feelings for you. You were her son, and she loved you till the day she died.
Yeah, well. You think that if it makes you happy. I can't taste these. You always get it wrong, don't you? I don't know why you bother coming.
Nor do I. No. I'm sorry, son, I didn't mean that. You know I'll always be here for you.
Morning.
usual, I know, for the beneficiaries to be called together for a reading of the will, but in this instance, Mrs. Cunningham Jarvis agreed with me that it might be the best course. The value of the stocks and shares on the 2nd of June amounted to some £721,043.
Good God!
In addition, there were some unit trust funds amounting to £141,000, and Mrs. Cunningham Jarvis owned the house, currently valued at £700,000.
That's over £1.5 million, are you sure?
Quite sure, Squadron Leader. Now, if you'd allow me?
Oh, absolutely. Fire away.
I desire that my husband, if I should predecease him, be permitted to live in our home, The Cedars, Neville Park, but that after his death, it be sold, the proceeds going to the British Association for Adoption and Fostering to aid those who are childless. I bequeath to my husband, Reginald Vivian Cunningham Jarvis, £10,000 a year. The remainder of my property I leave to my beloved nieces, Celia and Felicity Cunningham Jarvis, to be divided between them in equal shares and held in trust until they shall marry or until they shall have attained the age of 30, whichever is the sooner. Roughly speaking, that means about £400,000 for each of you after payment of estate duty. Your wife asked me to hand you this letter in the event of her dying before you.
Fine.
Darling Reggie, I hope all this didn't come as too much of a shock to you. And I hope you won't miss what you never knew you might get, if you see what I mean. As for Felicity and Celia, they're dear girls, and they had rather a rough time when their father remarried. I don't think Susan really cares for them much. And I wanted them to have some independence. So don't be too cross with me, Reggie. I think I've left enough for you not to have to pull your horns in too much. But after what happened, I just...
No!
I know I haven't been a very exciting wife. But I have loved you. And I wish I'd been able to say it more often. Marriage is a funny thing, isn't it? It isn't easy. It's not what you expect it's going to be. We've had a rather English marriage, I think.
Mr. Southgate and Squadron Leader Cunningham Jarvis. Now, I've had a rather wild idea.
I'll show you what would be your quarters. Well, here we are. This would be yours.
Yeah, very nice. Big room, just for one.
Is it? Oh, yeah, I suppose some people might think so. Wardrobe, chest, usual garbage, room, bathroom, right next door.
What do you think, some of the places we slept in during the war?
Absolutely. Who are you with?
Pioneer Corps. We were on D-Day. Right through to the end.
Jolly useful job you chaps did too. Great days. Great days. Best years of your life, bar none.
Always wondered who they were. These blokes who really enjoyed their war.
Oh, now you've met one.
Yeah.
Very good. Right, shall we downstairs and have a bit of a conclave. Sure you won't?
A bit early for me, thanks.
Been a while, I'm sure. Now, look here, Southgate. This notion the little posse from the social services dreamt up, it looks a bit strange at first blush, but there might be something in it. What do you say?
Well, the way she put it to me was that you could do with a bit of help on the domestic side, cooking and that, and we could both do with a bit of company.
Yes, what I was thinking of was more the practical arrangement. I've been eating at the local, mostly, Feathers, getting a bit sick of it. I'm not much of a cook myself. I left all that to Mary. But I gather from that popsy, you're rather a whiz in that department.
There's not much I can't do. Mind you, I'm more inclined to the traditional stuff, roast and three veg, steak and kidney pie, steamed pud sort of thing.
Oh, jolly good, excellent. And I suppose on your side, what you get is the free accommodation.
I've got a house of my own, thanks.
Oh, yes, yes, but heating, etc., your own rooms, run of the house, garden, you drive?
Anything and everything.
Including mill flats, I gather. Well, you could use the old motor for the supermarket run. And yes, why not? Have the use of the car yourself when I don't need it.
Really? Thanks. Very kind of you.
Well, what do you say? Give it a whirl, shall we?
All right. Yeah. Oh, yeah, there is one thing. What do we call each other?
Good point. I suppose I call you Southgate, you call me Squadron Leader. How'd that be?
Yeah, you sure you wouldn't prefer Sir?
Well, a bit formal, don't you think? So, move your stuff round at the weekend and I'll run you round in the Elvis. Can't say fairer than that. What? What?
OK. You're on.
Jolly good.
Weird old stick. If you don't like it, we don't have to stay. And we'll be popping back weekends. Make sure everything's all right at home.
Pennsylvania 65,000.
If you could lay the table.
Right, Roger. Look out. Excellent, Southgate. Well done.
Not bad, was it?
Not bad at all. Now, look here. I thought I might go down to the pub for a couple or three. I don't suppose you'd care to... No, you're not much of a drinking man, are you? Jolly good. Jolly good start. I might be rather late back, so you go up when you're ready. Don't wait up. Got me key, right?
And I'm to clear the supper things and wash up, am I?
Well, all in your own good time, no urgency. Damn fine dinner, that. Southgate, appreciate it very much. Cheerio! Well, let's face it, in a dogfight, the tidier you turn, the more chance you've got. I mean, and by God, the Spitfire had one hell of a tight turn. One hell of a tight turn. I mean, he just flipped over like that. Jerry never knew what hit him.
Well, that's it, isn't it?
What?
Know-how.
Yes, damn right. Another one in there.
You see, the way I see it, Squadron Leader, you take your life in your hands every time you step into an aeroplane.
Oh, that's not so, Jimbo. Not if you know what you're doing. Now, take the Messerschmitt, for instance. Fine aircraft.
What a day. Stock taking, what a nightmare. Scotch and sympathy required.
Allow me. Glenmorangie for the lady. Make it a large one.
Well, I don't know who you are, but the way I feel at the moment sounds like a lifesaver. That'd be lovely, thanks.
Smoke?
Oh, dear. I don't know. Well, yeah, go on, lead me astray. Oh, I'm Elizabeth Franks, by the way. But everyone calls me Liz.
I'm Reginald Cunningham Judds. Everyone calls me Reggie.
Cheers, Reggie. Have you any children, Reggie?
Nope.
Lucky man. I shouldn't say that, mine are darlings, but God, one never stops worrying.
Prep school, are they?
That's very gallant of you, Reggie. They're a little bit older than that. Hugo's doing that round the world thing. And Alicia, she did a bit of modelling.
Takes after her mother, then.
Well, thank you, kind sir. And now she's trying out catering. One just wishes they'd, you know, settled down and get on with their lives.
Absolutely. I mean, for me, it was straight out of the RAF into the family farm. I'm still very active there. The chairman's my nephew, Lord Blythe Gowrie. I still think of him as young Vivian. Still reckon he could do with a steadying hand.
Yes, and I bet you're just the man for it. Might I ask what the family firm is?
Cunningham Jarvis, London, Hong Kong, big trading company. I believe we started in opium.
Ooh.
Although that was well before my time. It's all above board now. And you?
Oh, very small beer compared to that. I have a little boutique in the Pantiles. Designer labels for the discerning woman of a certain age. And though I say it as shouldn't, I do think I'm a bit special.
I'll drink to that.
You're so sweet, Reggie. I don't believe you're real.
I'm real enough. Large as life, twice as ugly.
And I wouldn't say that either.
Tell me, Southgate, what do you do for women?
Well, nothing now.
Hell of a problem, right?
Not for me. You see, I never really wanted anyone but Grace.
No, sir.
Right from the off. Of course, we was both a bit shy to begin with. Took us a bit of time to get the hang of it. But after that...
Yeah, no debate. Nothing to beat it, eh?
Every night of our married life.
Really?
No, not more than that when we was younger. So, you're right, I do miss it, but it's much more her I miss. I can't really imagine doing it with anyone else. I expect you feel the same about your wife.
Well, not really, no. Well, there's more in you than me, Ciara, Sunday Jim.
By the way, don't forget I've got the car tomorrow. I'm going to see my son.
Yep, fine.
You sure?
You said so, didn't I? Oh, so you're a beggar and no mistake. I mean, I've heard of chaps who've stuck to one woman the hell of their lives. I've never met one till now. Strange world. I mean, I've had more women than I can remember. You were just the one, but on the other hand, if what you say is true, then you must have had a hell of a lot more jumps than I have. So who's the winner there, then, eh?
Didn't think it was a competition.
You are a prissy little tight-ass bastard, aren't you, Southend?
If you say so, sir.
Hello?
Is that still the right number for Sabrina?
Just see if she's free, sir. Who should I say it is?
Tell it's the squadron leader, Reggie. It's been a while, but she'll remember.
I'm sure she will, sir. I remember you very well. Lovely to hear from you again. Just hold on a second, squadron leader. Squadron leader Reggie.
Oh, yes. Hang on.
Just hold on, sir. Thank you.
Yes, here he is. Posh old geezer. Straight six. Got it up last time, and he calls it the big bad boy. Sweet.
Here she is, sir.
Reggie, darling. I thought you'd forgotten all about me. So how's that big bad boy of yours?
A bit out of practice since you mentioned it.
Oh, I'm sure he'll be raring to go. So when can you come?
Wednesday, day after tomorrow.
Wednesday? I've got a cancellation tomorrow at 3.
All right, I'll see you then. Southgate, look here, about tomorrow.
Yeah, I've got to leave early if that's all right.
Well, that's just it, you see. All off, operation scrubbed. Need the car myself, going to London.
No, you can't do that, squadron leader. You promised. And I've made all the arrangements.
Well, you just have to unmake them, won't you? You need the car, you see. Tell him you'll make it the week after.
No, that's no good. Alan's expecting me tomorrow. I can't let him down. I've got to have that car.
Well, I've got to about it. It's my car, not yours. I said you could have the use of the car and I didn't need it myself, but I do happen to need it myself tomorrow. All right, end of story. Any biscuits?
You promised me. I asked you if it was definite, and you said yeah. And now you're trying to go back on it. You call yourself a gentleman. Where I come from, a gentleman is somebody who keeps his word. You think I'm just an unpaid servant, don't you? You think you can treat me any way you like. Well, you can't. Either I have that car tomorrow, and that's it. I'm packing me bags. Make your mind up.
Oh, good God, man, keep your hair on. You're going to have the bloody car. It means so much to you. Well, I'll go up by train. Suit me better, as a matter of fact. And London's a bit of a nightmare these days.
Good. That's settled, then. Thank you.
So, you get to drive his Elvis, and what does he get?
Well, he's like a lot of these Neville Park types. He's got no idea how to look after himself. I do the cooking, things around the house. It works out all right.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. What's wrong with that?
And he gives the orders, and you take them, right? Mum's dead, and you don't feel right unless you've got someone to boss you about, do you?
It isn't like that at all, Alan.
So what's he like in bed, then?
Yes?
Squadron leader.
Up you come.
Anytime, old chap, anytime. Just say the word. You know they say, Southgate, about a man being as old as he feels?
Yeah?
Well, I'm here to tell you they are bloody well right. Here.
Glad to hear it.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I've had such a lovely time tonight, Reggie.
How about a nightcab back at my place? You haven't seen it, have you? It's just around the corner from here.
That's sweet of you, but I've got my car here, haven't I?
You're very sweet too, Liz.
Bless you. You know I'd love to, but...
It means a lot to me. Meeting you has been the best thing that's happened to me since God knows when. Say yes. Say you'll say yes.
All right, then, but only on condition that we go there in my car.
Absolutely. Jolly good idea. Chocks away.
Chocks away, squadron leader. Lovely house.
Yes, over the porch it says 1899. So what do you say? One more just for badness.
No, I mustn't. I really should be going. It's long past midnight.
You're a lovely girl.
Oh, Reggie.
Liz. You're so exciting.
Oh, Reggie. Don't. I never meant...
I want to make love to you more than anything in the world.
Oh, Richie, I don't know. It's much too soon. We hardly know each other.
I think we do, you know.
Oh, dear. Kiss me again.
Thank you.
mean, it can't be that one. You told me you lived alone.
I do. It's just Southgate.
Oh, no, Southgate.
Just a man. Just a servant. A manservant.
Manservant?
Yes, you don't have to worry about him. Come on, darling. Let's go upstairs.
No, no, no. It doesn't feel right now. I couldn't now. Not with someone else here.
Come on.
No. I'm sorry, Reggie. I should never have come back to you. It wasn't fair on you.
You can't leave me like this.
No, let me go. It is late, and I've got an early start tomorrow. It's been a lovely evening, Reggie. Thank you.
Southgate, I suppose you realise you've ruined my whole fucking evening. Home and dry, and you're gonna have to cough it up with your weak bladder. You're about as much bloody use as a fart in a bottle. Good night. No, I realise it wasn't your fault. Bloody woman just panicked. Strange creatures, women, like bloody antelopes. One wrong sound, they panic. One another?
Yeah, I don't mind if I do.
Oh, getting the hang of this whiskey drinking, aren't you?
Well, it's your birthday, isn't it?
I never thought I'd be spending it like this. Still, good dinner, good whiskey. Who needs women? You ever been to Scotland, Southgate?
Matter of fact, we were stationed in Kinloss for a bit.
When I was a boy, we used to spend a whole month up there every year.
Just like royalty.
Yeah, just like royalty. They go to Balmoral. We went to Roxburghshire, Blairgowrie Castle. Well,
you had a castle?
Of course we had a castle. Not anymore, bloody Vivian Lord Blythe Gowrie. Can't justify the continued expense, bloody tow rag. Oh, we had the best of times, Southgate. Just once a year we had this bloody great party. Everyone was equal, you see. All pistols, rats, dancing reels, all the family, guests, keepers, kitchen maids, and there were one or two of them, I tell you. Now I'm going to make do with you.
And vice versa.
So, we keep our peckers up. We're not dismayed. I know what we need. A bit of music. Now, let's see what we've got over here, shall we? I remember this. I remember this one. I think you'll remember this one, Southgate. I love to get you on a slow boat to China, all to myself alone.
Ah. Come on, Southgate, on your feet.
What for?
Oh, don't argue the toss with me. Come on, get up. Come on, turn round now. Put your arms there. No.
I'd love to get you. Thank you, Southgate.
My pleasure, sir. Happy birthday.
Italy? Why didn't you say before? Who are you going with, anyway?
Just friends, Reggie. Believe me, I'm not giving you the runaround. It's partly a buying trip for the shop. And I'll give you a ring the moment I get back. Promise.
I'll see you when I see you, then. What is it?
Just checking it's all right for me to have the car this afternoon.
Said so, didn't I?
You got the keys?
Take it and welcome. There you are.
Thank you.
Got a letter from June to say she's found another bloke. And I hope that one day I'll be able to forgive you for what you did to me. Silly cow. It was nothing to do with her, nothing. And she never really cared, not really. It was never a proper marriage. We was both of us just going through the motions, so to speak.
She was terribly upset, Alan. We all were.
She thought I had a girl on the side. Got the shock of her life when she found out.
Well, you could say we all did. Broke your mother's heart.
Bollocks. She never cared enough for me for that. It was just another example of me letting her down. Nothing any of us could do was good enough for her. Vera had to go all the way to Australia to get away
from her. I'm not listening to this.
No, you never did listen, did you? Always took her side. You don't get it, do you? You made me like this, and you want to know why? Because you and her made me feel like nothing.
You disgust me.
I know. I always did.
On the terrace. Hot enough for you? Time flies, eh?
Yeah, sorry I'm a bit late. I'll get the supper on.
Oh, bugger that. Don't want your long-suffering act. Come on, man. Sit down, have a drink, enjoy life. Dinner can wait a bit.
Righto. Yeah, I'll have a small one.
Oh, you'll have a small one. Splendid. We'd all drop dead of astonishment if he asked for a large one. Cheers. What sort of day you have?
I wouldn't say pleasant.
He's in jug, your son, isn't he?
What makes you say that?
Just guessed. Come on, am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
It's all right, man. Not your fault. Can't be responsible for him all of your life. What did he do? No need to say if you don't want to.
Rather not, if you don't mind.
Fair enough, fair enough. These things happen in the best of families, you know. Nothing to be done about it. All you can do is just get on with it.
That's it. I can't see where we went wrong with him. All we wanted was for him to be happy.
Of course it is. Just one of those things. Damn shame. But you're not to blame. Bad show, end of story.
It isn't as if we didn't set him a good example, his mum and me. We was always happily married, me and Grace. We had a wonderful marriage. Darby and Joan, people used to call us.
So you say. I don't think anybody ever said that about me and Mary. I don't think I'd have liked it if they had. We rubbed along all right. I had a few flings, nothing serious. She always forgave me, if she found out, that is. Never talked much. Didn't see the need for it. Miss her, though.
Yeah. Yeah. But, you know, it does get a bit easier as time passes. Never thought it would, but it does.
She was very fond of dogs. We used to have two of them, labs. They were called Huntley and Palmer. Dead now, of course, years ago. She loved those dogs. Getting a bit chilly. Yeah.
Bit of supper.
Oh. Dinner, Southgate, dinner. Absolutely useless. Talk to your bloody self. Come on.
Cheek to cheek, buongiorno.
Could I speak to Mrs. Franks, if she's there?
Reggie, darling.
Why didn't you tell me you were back?
Reggie, I was just about to when you phoned. I had a million things to do.
A million things more important than me.
Oh, darling, please don't be like that.
Who's that chap? In your shop? Well, I happen to be passing Tuesday. I found you. He was kissing you.
Oh. Oh! Darling, that was Colin. He's got the art gallery across the way. He's a mate. And he's gay.
He's a puffer?
Yes.
Oh. Then there isn't anyone else.
No, there isn't anybody else.
If there were someone else, if you were giving me the runaround, I don't think I could bear that, Liz.
Yes, I know it's all right, Reggie, but you have to understand that I'm a woman.
I had grasped that.
And I need to be quite sure of my feelings. Please don't rush me, Reggie.
Good Lord, no. Not for the world. This chap's looking a bit picky. Wait up. What you said, I quite understand. Absolutely. But on the other hand, I'm a man. I can't hold out forever.
Yes? What? Southgate? What the hell are you bothering me for? Oh, all right, don't tell me. Hell, I'll lie. Southgate! Phone! Hold the line. Southgate, phone for you. Take it downstairs and tell him not to phone you here again.
Speaking? Yeah? I'll do that. Yeah, right away. Yeah. Thanks for letting me know.
Yeah. Who the hell was that? Bloody outrageous.
It was the prison. My son's dead. Is it all right if I take the car?
God. Bloody rotten luck. Yes, of course you can take the car, old chap. A bloody awful thing. I'll just get out of your way.
We are extremely sorry about this, Mr. Southgate. It wasn't simply a cry for help. He clearly wanted to end his own life. There's always the possibility in these particular circumstances as the release date looms. But your son had no anxiety that we could detect about going back into society. And he had people who cared about him. Not many fathers would have stood by their sons as you have, Mr. Southgate.
I want him to have a proper funeral.
Yes, of course. And could I just say again how sorry we are, Mr. Southgate?
Yeah, I know. It wasn't your fault.
He's at peace now, Grace. That's the way we've got to look at it. We did our best for him.
32 separate offences. And all with the same lad. He said he was in love with him. 14-year-old boy. He'd never admit there was anything wrong in it. Of course, they put a restraining order on him. He said, if I can't see Jerry again, I don't want to live. What makes somebody go wrong like that? Was it my fault, though? I was always hard on him, you know, strict. Maybe we both expected too much of him.
Absolute bloody rubbish. People make their own bloody messes. It's not as if you beat the boy black and blue, is it? All you can do is tell them what's right as you see it. The rest is up to them. You love that boy of yours. No fool can see that. Not your fault. Nothing to reproach yourself with. Nothing at all.
No!
Are you suggesting that I should sell up to become a shop assistant?
Wouldn't really be all that different from what you're doing now, would it? And you'll be taking home regular money every week. No worries, no sleepless nights. We all have to swallow our pride sometimes.
How old are you, Mr. Whittington?
32. I can't help it, Mrs. Franks. I have to work to strict guidelines. The bank will extend your business loan for another 30 days. After that, either we see regular reducing payments or we'll call in the loan. I'll confirm this in writing.
Yes, what?
Reggie, darling, it's Liz.
Liz, how are you? Long time no see.
Well, whose fault was that? I've been waiting by the phone.
Well, I thought I'd give you a bit of space. Isn't that what they say nowadays? Anyway, what are you doing Friday?
Nothing. Or if I was, I've just cancelled it.
How about dinner here? Nothing elaborate. My man can look after us.
There's nothing I'd like better.
Very good. About eight? How's it going?
I bring it under control.
Oh, Storks.
I don't know. Go out and sit on the terrace. I'll bring you a drink.
Oh, darling, what's that? Bims? Excellent. Pour away. Have one yourself. Take the weight off. Calm before the storm, eh? No, not in that glass. Put yours in there, huh? Jolly good Pims, that. Cheers.
Cheers. I wanted to say, I know we've had our ups and downs, but I'm glad I've come here to help you out.
So am I, Southgate. Never regretted it for a moment.
Will you be popping the question tonight, if you don't mind me asking?
None of your damn business. Well, I rather thought I would, as a matter of fact. How did you know?
Instinct got a nose for these things. Now, don't take this wrong, but if it was to go well for you tonight and Mrs. Franks moves in, what with Alan having passed away and that, I should want to move out.
Really? I never thought of that. Thought you'd remain here. Got used to you now, part of the furniture. Out of the woodwork.
I know. I'm not saying it wouldn't be a wrench, but it wouldn't work. She'd understand that.
No, this is damn silly. I need you here.
I won't leave you stranded. I can call in now and again, do a spot of cleaning and that, you know, for the time being, till you find someone else.
Is that just a matter of going round with a Hoover?
I know that. I mean, it's not easy for me either. I've been happy here, looking back on it. You took me out myself, and I needed that. You've looked after me, and I've looked after you. We've been almost like a couple in a way.
What?
Well, like a kind of a married sort of a thing.
Have you gone off your rocker, Southgate?
I'll just go check on things in the kitchen. That could be a car. Best of luck.
You look lovely, Liz.
Sweet man.
This is Southgate. Southgate, this is Mrs. Franks.
Good evening, madam.
Good evening.
I've set the drinks on the terrace, seeing as it's a warm evening, or would you prefer them inside?
Oh, what do you think? Will it be chilly out there in that dress?
Oh, I think the terrace sounds wonderful. What a lovely idea. Thank you, Southgate. Glorious.
You should have seen it a few weeks ago.
Well, I think you've got yourself a little paradise here.
It can get a bit lonely.
Can it?
Would you care for a Pims?
Pims? Oh, Reggie, you are clever. That's absolutely perfect.
Squadron Leader, Madam, dinner is served whenever you're ready.
Well, quite as much, really. It turns out she's been playing the stock market for 30 years without saying a word to anybody about it. Except her stockbroker, I suppose, extraordinary.
Successfully, I hope.
Mm, running up to nearly a million. Never knew she had a dinner.
She sounds the exact opposite of my ex-husband. He was much better at spending it. I was left with two small children and a pile of debts.
What a bounder.
That's exactly what he was. But still, here I am.
Yes, here you are. I'm very glad to say.
Squadron leader.
Yes, all done.
Excuse me, madam.
Thank you, Southgate. That was delicious.
Thank you, madam. The desserts and cheese are on the sideboard. Would you like me to serve, or shall I?
No, we'll be fine. You can take yourself off for the night.
Thank you very much, Squadron Leader. I'll call in the morning. Good night, madam. Glad you enjoyed your dinner.
Good night, Southgate.
Good night, Squadron Leader.
Well done. He goes to Cambridge, has another cup of tea, some more sandwiches with the chaps there, then he flies back to Biggin Hill.
But weren't you terrified when you went out on these missions?
No, not when you were up there. No time. You just got on with it. You went up there alone. Good chaps either side of you. They look after you, you look after them. And afterwards, when you landed, Christ, you felt so alive.
Don't you wish you had children so you could tell them all about it?
No. No, they wouldn't understand. How could they? We made England safe for you? Oh, bugger off, you old fart.
Take it!
We did have a child.
What?
We did have a child. A little girl, lovely, lovely little thing. Her name was Cecily. We called her Tish or Tishy for some reason. 2 years old, 2 and a half. Good little walker, big for her age. Always pulling on her reins. I always remember that. You don't see them now, do you? Those little harness things with long straps.
Yes, I remember them.
Anyway, we're out in the town, Saturday shopping. Just out. Mary wanted to pop in somewhere, haberdashers. Something. Left me holding the rain. But I don't know if something caught my attention. Look back.
Titi! No!
Died instantly. My fault, you see.
I'm so sorry. I'm so dreadfully sorry. Poor Reggie.
No, not poor Reggie. It was my fault. No good telling me any different. It was my fault.
Reggie, it was an accident. How could you have known?
I should have looked after her, and I didn't. Cecily Berry. Aged 2 and a half. Beloved only child. Killed. By her father's carelessness. I've never said that before. Never admitted it. Mary never put it into words either. It buggered our marriage, though. She wouldn't let me into bed for a year. When she did, I couldn't. Guilt, I suppose. What do you think of me now, then? Not much of a man, eh?
Oh, Reggie, my poor darling, you're quite enough of a man for me. Come on, let's go upstairs.
You won't leave me.
I won't leave you, my darling.
And you'll marry me. Will you marry me?
Of course I'll marry you.
Liz, I've been so awful. But it will be different with you. Promise.
You're not awful at all. You're a very dear old heffalump. Come on.
Oh, not sure the old hydraulics will be in good working order tonight.
Darling, don't worry. I just want to be close to you.
Oh, good. I was hoping you'd say that. Rule it out altogether, mind.
Just you and nobody else but you. Undo me, please. Something stirred.
It's a big bad boy.
Oh, Reggie, it's huge. Be careful, darling.
My bonnie lies over the ocean. My bonnie lies over the sea. My bonnie lies over the ocean. Oh, bring back my bonnie to me.
to dash now. I don't want the servants to find me here. Reggie. I had a lovely time last night. Give me a ring at the shop when you're up and about. Bye, darling.
Morning. Got your cup of tea. Yeah. Ooh, another lovely morning. Come on then, let's be having you. Yeah, what are you saying? Well, I can't make. Yeah, come on. Oh, yeah. I'll call an ambulance. Mandy Hume, the social worker, come round yesterday. We had a bit of a chat about some, you know, what next.
Yes, my pride and joy. We're doing ever so well, aren't we, Reggie? We walked 6 steps yesterday. See you later.
I'll be off then. Anything you want bringing next time I come? Television? Liz Anne. Liz Franks, your lady friend. Has she been to see you yet? Is that a fact? I'll see what I can do.
He asks for you every time I go in, Mrs. Franks.
To be honest, I'm not awfully good at hospitals, but yes, tell him of course I'll go. Thank you, Southgate.
Oh, Southgate, Vivian, this is my man, Southgate. My nephew, Lord Blythe.
Pleased to meet you, sir.
Gather you're the one that found him. Well done. Pity you couldn't have gone in touch with me sooner.
Yeah, but it's not as if he was in regular touch, is it, sir? I mean, I knew he had a nephew called Lord something. Glen Morangio, I thought it might have been, but that's the Scotch, isn't it?
We are very proud of the squadron leader. He's making marvellous progress.
Can I have a cigarette then, please?
I'm afraid not. Fewer cigarettes in the first place, and you probably wouldn't be where you are now.
Squadron leader, I'll pop along to the shop, get your telegraph.
Now, look here. I think we should do some planning. Might be a couple of weeks before I can get down again. Who is that?
It's my fiancé.
Excuse me.
Darling, how are you?
That's the better for seeing you.
You must be Lord Blythe Gowrie, Liz Franks.
How do you do?
I'm delighted to meet you at last. So sorry it should be round his hospital bed. Oh, poor Reggie. Such rotten luck.
Yes. Am I to understand that this is an official engagement?
It's very recent. Though we have been together for quite a while, haven't we, darling?
Well, I'm sure you'd like a little time to yourselves.
Oh.
Southgate,
Could I have a word?
What do you know about this woman, Liz Franks? Oh, she's gold digger, isn't she? She thinks she's on to a good thing.
Hardly for me to say, sir.
No, well, she isn't. The sooner she knows it, the better. She sees a wealthy old man liable to drop dead at any moment, but she ought to know that as his widow, she'd get virtually nothing, not even the house. So if she sees herself as the merry widow, and I have no doubt that she does, she ought to be speedily enlightened. Now, are you going to put her in the picture or am I?
I'll do it.
Yes, well, fair enough. And refer it to me if she needs any confirmation. Now, my uncle's going to need long-term residential care.
I'll look after him. He'd rather be at home. I'd be happy to do it.
Really? But, look here, are you sure you're up to it?
I looked after my wife the best part of a year before she died. Did everything for her. Yeah, I'd want to look after the squadron leader. We've got used to each other, see?
And how much would you expect to be paid for your services?
I don't want your money. I've got me pension. We managed before, we'll manage again. Thanks very much.
Thank you for telling me.
I'm very sorry, madam.
Oh, for Christ's sake, do you mind not calling me madam? Do you needn't pretend you're sorry, either.
I've nothing against you, Mrs. Franks. I never thought you was after his money.
The bloody awful thing is, though, he was right in a way, that horrible man. I can't afford to be left with nothing.
That's what I thought. You will tell him, won't you? You won't just...
Yes. I'll tell him.
Darling! There she is. That's my fiancée. My lovely girl.
Reggie. Reggie, sweetie. Is there somewhere private we can go and talk?
A day room. Bit of a hole. We can smoke there, though. Southgate smells a minute. It's a good egg, Southgate.
Okay.
There we are!
You get a bit on that. What do you think? I can do twice around the ward now. They say I can go home in about a week. Not bad, eh?
It's very good, Reggie.
You will come and live with me, will you? I come out. We could get married right away, or wait, see how I turn out. You don't have to. They want to tie you down. You're still young, my darling.
Reggie, I've done wrong. I can't marry you. I should never have agreed. I'm going away, abroad, almost at once.
Where are you going?
I'm going to Italy.
And there's some chap, some young chap in that boat.
No, it's not a chap. Oh, Reggie, darling, you're very sweet. But I am going to leave you. There's no point in saying sorry or anything. I won't even say that I would never have made you happy. But I'm not a nice person.
I thought we could have children.
Reggie, darling, I'm 52.
That's extraordinary. Still, you look like a young girl to me. Will I see you again?
No, I don't think so. though you never know.
It was that young little nephew of mine, wasn't it, sticking his nose in?
It was actually Southgate who put me in the picture. Did it quite tactfully.
Well, over now. You do look lovely, Liz.
Please, Richard, don't go on, I can't bear it.
Yeah, I've been trying to rain all day. Nothing come of it in the end.
What did you say to her?
Your nephew would have told her if I hadn't. She'd had to find out sooner or later. Only fair she should know. I mean, it's true, isn't it? About the house and that.
Of course it's bloody well true, you bloody idiot, but you didn't have to spill the beans. She's gone now. Left me. And so you couldn't ruin my last chance of happiness.
Perhaps you're better off without her. I mean, if she was only after you because she thought you was rich.
Of course she thought I was rich, you bloody idiot! Why else do you think an attractive girl like that would want to marry me? I never thought she loved me. By God, I loved her. Southgate, what do you say to that?
No need to shout, sir.
I'm shouting in my life! Do you realize the things that you have of my love fuck on the earth?
Just as well by the look of you.
I'll
better be off. He's a little bit upset. Be back tomorrow, sir. Wait a minute. I'll give you Anne.
Thank you, Southgate. Home again. Diggity dig. Missed your cooking, Southgate.
What have you to say, sir?
Though I don't remember it always being as good as this.
All special occasion, pulled out all the stops. Found this wine in the cellar.
Did you? Very nice, too. Bloody hell, I've been saving her for about 7 years. 70 years and 10.
I think it's about time we started living for today. Don't you, sir?
Put right that, Southgate, you're absolutely right. Here's to us. Cheers.
The old firm back in business.
Except we're not a firm, and this is not a business.
No. Well, here's to us, then.
How about a brandy?
Better not. Not after the wine.
Oh, all right, you're the boss, Southgate.
Tell you what, we'll have a bit of music. I was looking through your records just yesterday. Remember this one? Moonlight Serenade, Glenn Miller, remember?
I should say so. We used to have a local harp at Biggin Hill every Tuesday.
Come on, then.
Oh, no, no, I'm not up to it.
Of course you are. Like riding a bike. Happy you get. I lead.